Do you think you know how big the universe is? If you think your answer is correct, don't get too happy. By the time I'm done with this sentence, the answer will be a different one, because the universe is expanding. In 1929, American astronomer Edwin Hubble looked at these really cool stars called Cepheids. Cepheids go through periods of time that last from a few days to some weeks, in which they start at a certain size, grow, and then get back to that same size. And what makes these stars special is that there's a clear relationship between the period of the star and its luminosity, and that allows us to calculate how far away it is based on how bright it appears to be. Simple. So what does this have to do with the size or the expansion of the universe?
Well, Hubble, besides spotting differences in the brightness of these stars, found differences in their color. He found that the more distant Cepheids looked redder, and this is due to something called the Doppler effect.
When an object emitting sound or light is moving away from you, its waves stretch, causing changes in pitch for sound or changes in color for light. Like that car that just passed by me. As he was moving towards me, the pitch of the car was very high. As he started to move away, the pitch went down. The same thing happens to light. When an object emitting light is moving towards you, its light seems bluer. When it's moving away from you, the light seems redder. And what Hubble saw was that objects in deep space were found to have a Doppler shift interpretable as a relative velocity away from Earth. In other words, further galaxies move away faster from us than closer ones. Wait, what? Does that mean we're at the center of the universe? If the speed of other galaxies depends on their distance from Earth, then we must be. Well, no. Picture the universe as chocolate chip dough, where the dough is space and the chips are the galaxies. If the dough doubles in size, this chip that's 2 centimeters from this other chip will be 4 centimeters away. But this other chip that's 5 centimeters away will be 10 centimeters away. The same applies to any other chip you pick, like this one and this one. This means that there is no center of the universe. We aren't the center of the universe. Everything that is not very strongly bound by gravity is moving away from everything else at the same rate. Further objects just move away faster due to what I just showed you. But now, let's talk about the video's title, The Accelerating Expansion of the Universe. In the late 1990s, two cosmological research groups set out to discover the ultimate fate of the universe. These scientists, like Hubble, use stars' brightness to determine their distance. The only difference is that they use very bright supernovae instead of Cepheids, and this allowed them to measure way longer distances, as the light that these supernovae emit is 5 billion times brighter than that of the sun. But time and again, when they looked at these supernovae, they found that they appeared fainter and farther away than they were supposed to be. And this led to a groundbreaking discovery. They found that the expansion of the universe was accelerating. But what is making the expansion of the universe accelerate? Well, we have no clue, to a certain extent. We've attributed the acceleration of the universe to an unknown force called dark energy, which is invisible and is a sort of anti-gravity. And after this discovery, we came to the conclusion that the universe is made up of this. It's around 73% dark energy, 22% dark matter, and 5% normal matter, or atoms. How do we know this? Well, for that answer, we only have to look to Albert Einstein and his field equations. One of the most profound insights he made was the assertion that mass causes space to curve, and that fact helps us understand the geometry of the universe. Let's visualize that. Imagine a two-dimensional plane. This plane is the universe, and only for simplicity, it is imagined embedded in a two-dimensional arena. If a heavy ball is on the plane, which represents a large mass in space, the plane is deformed, so that it is no longer flat, but has a deepening. This means that if a spaceship were to travel on this plane, the deformation of space that would make this spaceship follow a curved path, not a straight one. And this is what the geometry of the universe consists of. Space is either curved on itself because the plane is filled with matter, hyperbolic and open because there is almost no matter, or just right. Flat. And when we weigh the universe, we always do so to conclude it is flat. So after this discovery, we looked out at the nearby galaxies, weighed them, and came to the conclusion that the amount of stuff with gravity out there accounted for 27% of what was needed to make the universe flat. The curious thing was that the amount of matter out there was 1/5 that number, meaning there's another mysterious substance out there that has gravity, dark matter, leaving us with this. And it is all that in conjunction. From Hubble's discoveries, to the supernova findings, to the theory surrounding dark energy and the proposed model of the universe, that we can conclude we live in an accelerating universe, full of questions to answer and challenges to fulfill.